1975, at the age of 20, Verity Taylor was charged by the police with damaging a chair by fire, value £6, in the locked ward of a mental hospital where she was a patient. She was remanded to custody to Holloway Prison for a period of 3 months. She was subsequently tried in Canterbury Crown Court. In February 1976, an order was given for her admission into a maximum security hospital. February 24, 1976, Verity Taylor was admitted to Broadmoor, from where she may not be discharged or transferred elsewhere without permission of the Home Secretary.
Dear whoever you are, find me and have me as your beloved.
Find me!
Find me!
Find me! Find me!
Children are quite alike. And then last
hope she's settled down.
And she hasn't.
No, if anything, she's... She's compelled to talk. She's not stupid. She's been very nice, very reasonable. They're quite pleased with the progress of the farmers.
She plays with other children, has friends.
No, she usually plays with them. She doesn't seem to get on the same wavelength with other children somehow. We've noticed that she veers between being little and high-spirited or close up at once. I mean, you get that, don't you, when children do the sorcery by nature. She always seems so much happier playing in their own little private world. When she was very small, she used to play for hours on end with the village that she made out of blocks.
There's the school, and the church, and here's all the houses, and here's the park, and this is the castle. It's my village. It's tiny, 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 and it's all mine. I'm big, and I look after all the people. I'll take care of you. I'll take care of you. I'll make a lovely big swimming pool, and here's where the horses live. There's 100 horses, and if they want, they can gallop through the whole village. Gallop, 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 down the streets, and jump over the hedges, and in the gardens, and...
Hello, Bert. What's that you're
making? Be careful, you'll step on it.
Alert. I'll be careful.
It's my village.
Oh, it's very nice. Clever girls.
This is my castle. I'm inside it.
Are you?
Yes. And no one else can get in.
Well.
It's all locked up and safe, and they can't get in.
Hello, darling. You're
Look out!
What?
You're knocking it over!
Well, honestly, Verity, you've taken up nearly the whole floor. Look, you'll have to move it now anyway.
Don't touch that!
We won't touch any of it, Verity. Put it away yourself.
I don't want to put it away. I want to play with it.
You can play with it later.
I don't want later. I want now.
We're going to have tea.
I don't care. Now. I want my village now.
Stop shouting like that and do as you're told.
What? What did you say? I'm deaf, I can't hear you, I'm deaf.
I said to do what I tell you!
You tell me. Mine! It isn't yours! I'll break it! I'm smashing it! You can't
Verity,
have it!
Verity, stop!
They're all dead now. They're killed. That's what you wanted. You wanted them killed.
I should go and talk to her.
I should leave her. Let her simmer down.
But Edward, she shouldn't be allowed to. We mustn't let her behave like that. But why does she do it? I don't understand.
All children have little temper tantrums. I mean, it's nothing out of the way. I'll speak to her later.
She doesn't do it to you. You don't know what she's like. Little temper tantrums. She torments me, Edward. Last week one night when you were away, she came bursting into the bedroom at about 3 o'clock in the morning with the radio turned up full blast. I made her turn it off, so she started dancing and stamping around the room and putting her head against the bed pretending to be a car. I tried to take her to bed with me, but she wouldn't let me touch her. I tried to take her back to her bedroom time and time again, but the moment I dropped off, she'd just come running back in again. There was nothing I could do. She just went on and on.
But why didn't you tell me?
No, because all I ever seemed to do is complain to you about her. All the mothers cope. I feel so inadequate. Nothing seems to satisfy her. I can't do anything right. I can't bear it. Sometimes I think I'll go mad. Last week when that happened, I actually wanted to get up and run out of the house into the night to get away from her, to escape from my own child. Sometimes I feel as though she's trying to punish me for something. As if she's trying to take some sort of revenge. But why does she do it, Edward? Why?
You're tired. Come on, I'll make you a cup of tea. You wait until she goes to school to make all the difference.
Do you really think so?
Of course it will. Once she comes up against kids her own age, you'll see.
Betty has tried very hard in class to the best of her ability and has made progress. She is still unreliable in her social behaviors out of class, lunch hours, etc. Verity has been very helpful as an early morning monitor. Come on, class two, hurry up.
I wish I didn't have to live at home. You never know what she's gonna do next. I can't bring my friends to the house. I wouldn't. I don't want them to know what she's like. When she watches something she likes on TV, she goes... And if she can't get what she wants, she runs around making an awful face saying, needs, needs, needs. She does that in the shop sometimes when Mum won't buy her something she wants. Everybody's staring. Sometimes. At night, she'd go all over the house, banging in and out of all our rooms. Dad's had to put locks on all the inside doors. I mean, when she gets like that, sometimes you just have to lock her out to get a bit of peace. She never even has meals with us, because all she does is jump around and grab things. She won't sit down and eat properly, so she has to eat by herself. I don't know. There's nobody I can talk to. Nobody I can tell about. Mum would just get upset. Crying. Dad would say to me, come along, Mark, old chap. You know it's not easy for Verity. Well, it's not easy for me either. We went on a camping holiday to France last summer. She spoiled everything. We went out one night to a restaurant.
For a treat. You'd like that, wouldn't you, Verity?
Oh, yes, may we. That's right, isn't it, Dad?
That's right, may we.
Everyone.
Come on, Mark.
messieurs. Bonsoir, madame. Bonsoir, mon. Asseyez-vous, je vous en prie, asseyez-vous. Good evening. Please do take a seat.
Je comprends, je comprends. Bonsoir.
Verity, sit down.
Oh, look, they've both lifted up. Hello, Orphans.
Sit down.
Sit here by me, Verity. Support Orphans.
Right through for the last fortnight.
wrote in school last week. She's learned it by heart.
Come on, Verity, let's hear it.
I'll bet she didn't write it herself. Verity can't write poems.
I did. It's my poem. I wrote it in a book myself. Of course she did. I bet it's very good. Go on, Verity. Listen to the old mill creak. The rain falls into old leaves. Silent ears hear. Suddenly the silence is broken by someone setting off a bell. Swishing through golden leaves, an owl hoots. A gull rushes to his home. The whispering dawn comes near as evening runs out of time. The sky is dark. The blue moon is out. As I walk slowly through the wood, its clenched, cracked swish, the leaves under my feet make a colorful noise.
Oh, hello.
And while we're eating, I'll stop the fireworks.
Oh, yes, Dad! Oh, yes!
Hooray!
And light the fire!
In the whole
girl.
Verity Taylor, sir.
Where's your swimming hat?
I haven't got it.
Well, run and fetch it.
I left it at home. I forgot it.
No one without a swimming cap is allowed to swim. You're not going to swim in the gala this afternoon, Verity.
No, no, no!
Don't be upset, Verity. Their hair is not the end of the world.
There will be another swimming gala next year. Who'll be able to swim in that one?
You're stupid, Verity. It was your own fault. There's no point in blaming anybody.
Don't tease her, Mark.
Will somebody say something, why don't you?
Don't touch me! Don't touch me! Leave me alone! Don't touch me! No, no, no! Neat, neat, neat!
Verity! Verity, where are you? What are you doing?
Oh, Edward, Edward, look! What are you doing with all my photographs and my letters? What are you doing with him? Oh, God, Edward, stop! What are you doing?
I can't sit all this out in the bathroom. Come out! Come out, Verity!
Dad, there's water coming out from under the door. She's flooding the bathroom. She'll flood the whole house.
Verity, stop that! Come out! Come out, Verity!
My God! My God! My God!
Stop her, Dad. I'm afraid.
Look out! Get out of my way! Look out! Can't you see? I'm the ball!
Do you have a doctor's letter? Yes.
I think you'd better see the assistant registrar. If the letter isn't from your old doctor, it's down the corridor into the left.
Some of the ones here have to sit with no clothes on in a small room. They just sit. Sometimes they throw themselves about.
Name, Taylor, E.J. Taylor. Patient's name, Verity Rose. Date of birth,
February the 13th, 1955.
Age?
11 years and 5 months.
Has your daughter been a patient here in the past?
No.
Or any other mental hospital?
No.
May I see your doctor's letter?
It isn't actually from my old doctor. He was away.
30?
Oh God, in your high heaven! Please, come and reveal for me. I need you now. Our Father.
to justify hospitalization. Can you give me some details of when did this happen?
Yesterday afternoon and evening. She broke three windows and locked herself into the bathroom and threaded it. She cut off lots of her hair and tore up a whole box full of letters and photographs. Just destroyed them utterly, threw them all over the room. And she dressed herself up in all sorts of strange clothes and ran out of the house.
We tried to catch her. She ran so fast, she was screaming and shouting and waving her arms about. We were terrified.
She was missing for 7 hours. We went out with friends looking for her until someone saw her knocking over dustbins outside of the school, spreading the rubbish over the pavement.
In the dark.
They called the police. We telephoned them, of course, already, but will the police know, Verity? They telephoned us. When we got to home, she wouldn't speak to us or look at us. She went straight into the kitchen and opened a tin of sardines and covered them in jam. She ate them out of the fingers.
She wouldn't go to bed. She lay under the kitchen table all night, and when we tried to touch her, she kicked and bit us.
Yes, yes, I see. And there is a history of erratic behavior.
Yes.
And no previous hospitalization.
No, but she has been attending the child guidance clinic since she was 9.
And there have been specific epileptic features.
Yes, she's been on medication for that for over 3 years now.
Well, now, I think the best thing to do before we go ahead with the mission is to have a see one of our psychiatric staff. Let Cordon up the stairs. We'll take this to the doctor.
Sometimes I feel afraid that I'll get lost in the dark mazes of Cordon's fear.
I'm sorry to keep you waiting so long. Your name is
Taylor. E.J. Taylor.
And your daughter's name?
Verity Rose.
Her ages?
11 years and 5 months. She was born on February the 13th, 1955.
Any previous hospital treatment?
No.
To justify hospitalization, can you tell me what happened?
They've asked us all this before.
It's just for the records.
She broke some windows. She cut off a lot of her hair and flooded the bathroom. She destroyed a box of letters and photographs and dressed in bizarre clothes and ran out of the house screaming. Police brought her back 7 hours later.
I see. And how are you feeling now, Verity?
She hasn't spoken at all since last night.
And she's been on drugs for epileptic symptoms for how long?
3 years.
No previous hospital care?
She's been going to the child guidance.
Well, I'd like to take Verity to see one of my colleagues, who's on staff at the talking board, room 1B. You may have to wait a little while, I'm afraid. It's a bank deposit, you see. Just down the corridor to the left.
I have a fear of being alone in a small room.
Date of birth?
February the 13th, 1955.
What exactly did she do?
Cut off her hair.
Screaming and waving her hands about.
Previous psychiatric treatment.
Child guidance.
A history of erratic behavior.
Yes.
How long has Verity been having treatment for epilepsy?
3 years.
Name.
Verity Rose Taylor.
How long was she missing from home?
7 hours.
Age? 7 years and 5 months.
Has Verity been in a mental hospital before?
No.
You could wait here, please.
Right above and corner.
May I see your doctor's letter?
Yes. Well.
I think we can admit Verity into our children's ward.
Do you think so today?
Well, I know it was that day, Jeeves.
Last time we visited her, she was quite placid. They said that it was worse than usual for her, but you've got to expect it sometime.
Last time? But she'd just been having that horrible shock treatment last time. I wouldn't have said placid, Edward. Confused. Miles away. Like a strange little old woman, not like a child. Why did they do it to her? It didn't do any good. No good at all.
They have to try every kind of treatment they can. She has been better. Some of them. And they think that if she comes out now, she'll settle down.
Why should she? What makes them think that? Look what happened when they left her home for Christmas.
But that was 6 months ago!
All my presents smell of old socks. Dad, you've been walking all over my Christmas presents with your dirty socks on.
Is that American? Of course I have.
Doesn't matter. I don't care anyways. I've smashed them all up and thrown them into the dustbin.
Oh, Verity.
Have a good time in the hospital, Betty!
child driving you to drink. Your own child that you love. I don't even know if I do love her. I don't know what I feel for her. Pity. Oh, yes, pity. Why did it have to happen? Poor parents. Poor, poor baby. She seems to like to fight me. Enjoys it. She never does it to Edward. Sometimes I feel as though she really hates me. And he's so good to her, so patient and kind. All those trips to Portugal. He never talks much about them afterwards, but I know she crucifies him. And I feel mean and cowardly because I don't go too. And guilty. Did I do it to her? Was it my fault? I was pregnant with her and she was inside of me. And I thought she was so safe. Yet all the time. Was it me? Did I contaminate her? Oh, God. She was so beautiful when she was pale. Even now, sometimes, when you look at her when she's asleep. Sometimes when I go out with her, I wish she was ugly, deformed, or crippled, something people could see. And then they would feel pity for us too, not just stare, nervous and embarrassed, and then walk away as though we were lepers. Will nobody help us? Can't anyone help us?
Dear sir, I am writing to you once again to request your help with our acute problems concerning our daughter. It is no exaggeration to say that my wife is quite at the end of her tether after years of trying to give this girl the opportunity of a happy home. I really fear for my wife's health if the situation continues as at present.
Dear Mr. Taylor, I sympathize with the difficulties you have in your daughter, but must tell you that there are, unfortunately, no establishments in this area for disturbed teenagers and young adults.
I understand that application has been made for our daughter in your residential unit. I am only writing to underline the urgency of the situation. Our youngest son, who is only 4, has been suffering acute mental distress in recent months, which has been manifested by lack of appetite, sleeplessness, and bedwetting. The headmistress at the nursery school she attends has offered to depose to the effect that his present home situation is having a severe effect on him.
I'm sorry to say, as we run the only adolescent unit in a very large area, we are inundated with requests and have no vacant places at present. We will, of course, put your daughter's name on our waiting list.
We can understand the reasons why the council cannot consider reading this into care, but I am writing to ask if there is not some sort of safety net provided by the council for cases of this sort.
Although we do ask that you accept that we all sympathize with you in the present situation regarding Verity, there is nothing that we as the rural directorate can do it for you at the present time, or even advise you to do.
Nothing.
I'm leaving home, Edward. And I'm taking Nikki with me.
Cold now. Come on with me and I'll make you some hot toast and tea. What? bit afraid in here. No, no, no. It's all right. It's a bit smaller. If you could just write them a note, Tom. Tell them I couldn't come in today because I had an upset tummy. I'll never be able to fill in those labels if I had an upset tummy.
Upset Tommy? After that breakfast? Honestly, Violet. Anyone would think you were a farm laborer or something.
I always did have a good appetite, my father used to say. Hello, dear. I think the child's dead, you know. Perhaps I could learn sign language.
Violet, get your hat and coat and get to work.
I feel giddy.
Planting bulbs in the window boxes.
Nope, Suzanne in her garden.
Would you like to help me?
No.
Okay.
What color?
Well, they're tulips, so I expect they'll be red and purple. Some of them will be white. What's your favorite color, Verity? When we get all these in, we'll take the boxes up and put them in the front windowsills. The sun's shining today and we'll water them. That way we'll get a good start. When it gets a bit warm, it'll be time to plant the seeds. Got lots of packets the other day.
Persuaded to take on a little part-time job soon.
Well, I hope you won't push on that one. Surely it's enough for now that you feel safe, contented.
I'm sure you can trust his judgment. I mean, he obviously cares for her.
Yes.
It really does seem as if it's the beginning of the way back for her.
Thank God.
Oh,
legs are all right, but I'm afraid she broke most of her bones in her feet.
I'm so sorry. I can't tell you how sorry I am. She was fine all day, no different from normal until supper time. I don't know what got into her. She just suddenly jumped up, knocked the table over, started smashing all the dishes, and then she ran upstairs. It all happened so fast, it... Of course, Mr. Taylor. Of course I'll take her back. If I possibly can.
Impossible.
But Tom Bark has written to us. He has a place for her, and he's willing to take her back.
Miss Taylor, when Verity first went to the halfway house 2 years ago, she lasted exactly 7 weeks. She related only to Barker, and that only minimally. And then the sudden total loss of control and the accident...
I know, but...
We've already tried it once. The trial weekend she spent there last year was a disaster.
Yes, but you see, Doctor, it's been the only place she seemed really happy. Couldn't we try it one more time?
I'm sorry. It's not a gamble we can afford to take again. Verity is simply not, you know, stability. That kind of environment. Look at the record, Mr. Taylor. At the general hospital where she's being treated for broken bones in her feet, she attacked one of the nurses. Which is why she was referred to me at this hospital.
But not attacked. She said she only
the report says severe concussion.
Well, that's because she hit her head when she fell. It wasn't Verity's fault.
Miss Taylor. In the 17 months since Verity's been admitted here, she's become less and less responsible for her actions. Less and less able to manage herself.
Well, isn't that part because you've got her locked in your geriatric ward? She's only 19, for God's sake.
It's the only ward in this hospital that's been able to contain her, Mr. Taylor.
Do you think I wanted to put her here? As far as I'm concerned, it's a last resort. We've tried everything else. In the last year, Verity has become increasingly disruptive and destructive. She breaks windows, she destroys property, she intimidates the other patients, and she torments the nurses. And as you know, she's absconded many, many times.
And that's because she's unhappy.
Yes.
We just feel that our loved one in a mental hospital is absolutely the wrong place for her.
So do I. So do we all. But there aren't many right places for a girl like that. I wish to God there were. There's never been enough money spent on facilities and staff to provide an environment for this kind of case, let alone research. We don't know how to help her. She's never responded in any sustained way to any kind of medical treatment or to psychotherapy. No doctor's been able to give a definite diagnosis in her case.
Well, locking her up with a lot of crazy old people isn't going to help.
The only alternative seems to be that she returns home to live with you. Shall we arrange that, Miss Taylor?
No.
No. No, Violet. We're not going to take her back. The consultant at the hospital said it wouldn't be wise.
He's right. I'm sorry, Tom. Is. She upset us. She wouldn't talk to any of us. Jeff used to run out to the house when she got her funny turns. Poor fellow. The last time she came here, she was very rude to you, Tom. She was. The language. I don't know what my father would have said.
She learned all that in the hospital. She's young. She picked all that up like a child does.
We need to be peaceful here, Tom. This place is our home for now. She frightened us.
I know. Yes, I know.
She looks old enough to take care of herself. And besides, she seems perfectly happy.
People might think she lives here.
So?
Well, look at her now. She looks a bit funny to me.
Ah, should go away for just ignoring her. I want to watch this. I've often thought of putting up for this program.
You, a mastermind.
Now, Dora, how many times have I been able to answer the questions before they did? Schopenhauer! Oh. But you must admit that we...
Go speak to her.
What do you want me to say to her?
Nasty.
He's a spy. I know it. My daughter's in too.
she's not responsible for her actions. And now she's to be prosecuted for £6 worth of damage to a wooden chair?
The fire service is called to the hospital when there's any kind of fire, no matter how small. The police arrived with them. They made their own inquiries to know whether, in my opinion, Verity was in a fit frame of mind when she did this. And I have no doubt that this was so.
Oh, Holloway! They can't be going to put her in Holloway, Edward.
Verity Taylor has been under my care as medical officer since her reception at Holloway. From reviewing her history, seeing her parents, and from my own observations, I believe she is a severely disturbed girl. Although I do not regard her as a dangerous patient, there is no doubt that she responds well to a firm, understanding, contained, and consistent environment. Ordinary mental hospitals are unable to contain or help her.
She's being committed to inherit that Canterbury Crown Court.
But what will happen to her? What will happen to her now?
Ideally, what Verity needs is a maximum security institution where she may not abscond, but there are sufficient nurses to give her individual attention and some form of psychotherapeutic program to help her undergo a behavioral modification. Unfortunately, the only institution that could provide this is Broadmoor.
As a consultant psychiatrist of Broadmoor Hospital, it is my opinion that she be contained for a prolonged period of treatment in conditions of security. In view of her long history and in order to provide statutory supervision, I suggest that under Section 65 of the Mental Health Act, a restriction order without limit of time be placed upon the discharge from hospital.
Taylor was charged by the police with damaging a chair by fire, value £6, in the locked vault of a mental hospital where she was a patient. She was remanded in custody to Holloway Prison for a period of 3 months. She was subsequently tried in Canterbury Crown Court, and in February 1976, an order was given for her admission into a maximum security hospital. On February the 24th, 1976, Verity Taylor was admitted to Broadmoor, from where she may not be discharged or transferred elsewhere without the permission of the Home Secretary.
Find me!
Oh,